This is such a big deal. It has to do with what we can find out about our elected leaders and what they're doing in Olympia and what they can keep secret from us. So a judge actually ruled that the lawmakers in Olympia have to follow our state's Public Records Act, and that means we can actually look at their emails and their text messages. If they're texting with a lobbyist, we need to know about it. We just have to file an official request. Last week, though, lawmakers were like, that's not going to happen. And they rushed through this Senate Bill 6617, and they gave themselves an exemption to the Public Records Act. So the proposal, they say, look, no big deal. It does release some information, like disciplinary reports and their schedules, so we can know if they're going to have lunch with Aunt Jim or Uncle Jim or whoever. But it keeps all the rest under wraps, including the records the judge ruled need to be made public. So look, let's take the big camera over here. I'm going to walk over, and I'm going to show you what a big deal this actually is, because today there are newspapers all over the state. There are like 9 of them at last count. In fact, this is 5 that have front page editorials demanding that the governor veto this bill. So take a closer look. Here's the front page of the Seattle Times. It says that hundreds of people have emailed the governor's office in recent days asking him to oppose this bill. Here's the News Tribune in Tacoma. Inslee must veto shameful bill. And here's the Everett Herald. Editors there even put it above their masthead. More important than the name of the newspaper. The Olympian, the Bellingham Herald, the Spokesman Review, the Yakima Herald, the Vancouver Columbian, all on the front page. Inslee was on MSNBC last night, and he said this bill is a bad one. But he stopped short of saying he was going to veto it. The thing is, he could decline to sign it, but it would still take effect immediately. And even if he vetoes it, remember the Senate passed this thing 41-7, the House 83-14, so lawmakers could override his veto if they want to. That is, unless voters are angry enough and scare them into not doing it. We'll have to wait and see if all of this public pressure actually results in this bill dying.